makes a fighter better, and I can go back and learn from this and move into bigger and better fights.
What did you feel from this opponent?
He was tough. You know, he kept coming. He took my best punches. He kept coming. Other than, you know, he didn't fold. I hit him with some body shots that definitely hurt him, but he kept coming because he's a warrior too. So when I hit him with those body shots, when he wanted to go down, he stayed up and kept pushing and kept those arms swinging. So that was the difference.
Did he hurt you?
He never hurt me, but I did, you know, his nonstop pressure and punches did fatigue me a little bit, but I was never hurt. And that's why I told her, you know, everybody, I was reassuring everybody in my corner, I'm not hurt, I'm good, you know what I mean? It's just a tough fight.
You've been busy. Yeah. Talk to us about how that activity has helped you get better.
You know, it's kind of like trial by fire. I'm 19 years old, so experience is what's going to make me as a fighter. That's why you got to stay busy. You got to experience different types of fighters. You got to experience fights like this, tough fights where you go into the trenches. And that's what's going to make me. This is where I'm learning. I'm learning on the job.
When did you want to fight before the end of the year?
Yeah. I'm going to fight in September and then probably before the end of the year as well after that.
At what point in the fight did you feel like those body shots were doing the damage that you were intended them to do?
Probably in the fifth round. I really started to see him, you know, I hurt him with one in particular, and then I followed up with it. And from that point on, he wasn't the same. That's why I was able to close out the show strong, you know, from the body work that I was doing. He had some good body work as well too.
Yeah.
And I think we were going to war on the inside, and it was a battle of body shots and coming back up to the head and who could land the better body shots. And I think that, you know, that's the spirit in me. I want to fight on the inside. I want to fight, you know, toe to toe. We were talking in there. It was a really competitive natured fight. There's been a lot of things going into this fight. I think the biggest thing I'm going to learn going into other fights, I've got boxing ability, you know, that I showed in the first couple rounds that, you know, when I start sitting in, I'm really wasting my boxing ability. I need to stay on the outside, keep the jab pumping, and just outbox these guys instead of going into a phone booth toe-to-toe fight. But that's just how I like to fight. I told the fans that before the fight, you know, and I doubt that's my last type of fight like that too.
It was probably the most entertaining fight tonight.
And that's what I love to hear, you know. We knew he was going to be tough. That's why my management put me in there with that type of fighter, because you got to learn off these type of fighters and these type of fights. So to hear, you know, I've had a lot of people tell me that was the best fight of the night. I love that. I've been seeing that all over, you know, social media and things like that. That was the fight of the night and one of the candidates for fight of the year. You know, we really brought a good show.
So when we getting back in the gym, or how long is your layoff?
Probably a week. You know, I'll be back in the gym. Yeah, I'll be back in the gym, training, working on my craft. You know, taking it all in and getting ready for September.
What's those conversations like in your head when you're like, I know I have the amateur pedigree to box on the outside, but God damn it, I got to fight this guy on the inside and try and win this fight.
It's so, you know, everything is mental in this game. So, you know, I'm like, use a jab, stay on the outside. But then I'm like, I'm going to knock this dude out right now.